My daughter to go see the Little Mermaid in Orlando, and this happened.
Oh, I need a refund on my ticket. No, we getting a refund because we need a refund.
What's going on?
This is a kid's movie. Oh my God.
Information is that it should stay private. Online privacy protection.
I'm afraid.
From Discover.
I don't want to be an independent woman anymore. It's not all that it's cracked up to be.
This message is for my future husband, so if you're not my future husband, please keep scrolling. Daddy, I don't want to work anymore.
Oh, I decided that I need me a sugar daddy, but I want me a sugar daddy that don't want no sugar.
That being this independent woman, paying all the bills, that's ghetto. Send my husband right now.
I don't know if anybody else has realized this, but this whole independent woman thing, you know, I don't need nobody. I can do bad all by myself. It's feeling like a scam.
I don't know who needs to hear this, but the whole independent, you know, I want to be independent. I got my own bag. Ladies, it's dead.
I know how Libby said. She got her own house. She got her own car. Two jobs, work hard. You a bad broad. I don't want to be a bad broad no more.
I started my own business and I worked as a girl boss for 7 years. Now that I turned 30, I've realized that actually I am a very dependent person. Yes, I am independent, but I'm someone who prefer depend on someone.
If you're hot and work at McDonald's, we're fucking you. It doesn't matter if you're a doctor.
Oh, she stinks like McDonald's.
Or if you're homeless. What?
You wanna F a McDonald's worker?
If she's hot.
That's dirty.
Why? Wait, hang on.
Why is it dirty to...
Like, why is it
have
dirty?
Have you ever picked up a McDonald's worker before? Like, they stink like McDonald's.
Oh, come
have
on.
You, I mean, they're gonna shower. Take a shower. Hello?
You're not...
Yeah, but
shower.
Like, you're also... Now it's on... I know you don't mean to do this, but now you're, like, disrespecting hardworking people that happen to work at McDonald's. It doesn't mean that they smell if they work there. It doesn't mean they're bad.
I'll date a girl who works at Chick-fil-A. I'll date a girl that works at McDonald's. In fact, I was there the other day.
Which one?
I saw a cutie.
Which one?
I saw a cutie at McDonald's.
At McDonald's? Yeah, yeah. She's bad?
Yeah, she's bad.
Yeah.
But like,
you asked
a woman,
if she wanted some fries with that?
Here,
did you get happy before the money?
I started getting older, you know? I just realized, like, life is short. I'm going to die.
it's, again, trite, right?
Trite.
In
trite.
Many ways.
Yeah, well, Confucius had a great saying that, you know, every man has two lives. And the second starts when he realizes he has just one.
Wow.
And I read that, and it was one of those book-dropping lines. You know, it's like mic drop. Confucius had a lot of mic drops.
Confucius was a bad motherfucker.
He was.
That's a crazy one.
That was a great one. Or another one is next time you get sick, you know, because everybody gets sick every mm-hmm. now and then. It's like a happy person wants 10,000 things. A sick person just wants one thing, mm. right? So it's your unlimited desires that are clouding your peace, your happiness. Have desires. You're a biological creature that stands up and says, I can do something. I move, I resist, I live. But just be very careful of your desires. This is the oldest, most trite wisdom. Desire is suffering. That's what it means, right? Every desire you have is an access where you will suffer. So just don't focus on more than one desire at a time. The universe is rigged in such a way that if you just want one thing and you focus on that, you'll get it. But everything else, you gotta let go.
Hey, 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 just letting you know, you got a new like. So just keep on swiping and you might find the love of your life.
Wow. All right, that was quite the notification, for sure.
Okay, who is it?
Well, about that.
You know, I'd love to hook y'all up and facilitate a meaningful relationship. I really would, but that's a premium feature, so you don't have to pay for that. Her name's Cynthia, though. Oh, okay, so that's how y'all make y'all's money.
Absolutely.
Okay, well, you lucky I'm
down bad. It's okay, don't worry. I mean, we all have those moments, that's why we're here.
Thank you kindly. Loneliness smells so good. Oh, Cynthia, come on out. I like funny guys and boat rides.
Word. Yeah, that's a hell of a bio right there.
Hey, how's it going? Do they?
Yeah, she's probably busy. You know, that active now status is kind of glitchy sometimes, so.
Yeah, this is typically how it goes. You want to try to stand out. Maybe try a pickup line.
All right. Are you from Tennessee because you're the only
But now you double texted, though, so.
Damn, I mean, what am I supposed to do then? I don't.
Yeah, so it's been like five.
Hi.
Out. Okay, I'm a.
Just a unmatch real quick.
Yeah, this ain't me. I'm just going to delete the app. I appreciate
this. Did you say delete the. Hey, insight. Whoa.
Wait. Hold on. Are you sure?
Yeah, I am.
Are you positive, though? Because mm-hmm. you just paid. I mean, once you.
That's cool. I really don't mind.
You gotta type in delete if you're really sure.
D-E-L-E-T.
In my running kit, locked inside the gym, I got his bell. This was too legit. Everything I said is real as hell. And they can't even tell the real from the fake, I wish him well. This song already was turned, but here's a bell. Hearing that, I know it's rich as hell. I just put it, and I feel like yell. We not bustery, we not can't have no semi-M.
So that is the wildfire in Banff right now. And fun fact, it was started as a controlled burn by the International Women in Firefighting Conference. Previous to this controlled burn getting out of control, they were posting articles about how this conference was happening and how they were going to be doing this controlled burn, and it was only going to have women. Like, no men were allowed to be a part of this controlled burn. And I'm not saying that women shouldn't be doing this stuff. Go them. Great for them to be a part of firefighting and, like, wildfire fighting. I'm just saying it's a little bit funny that they are so quiet now about who started it, and they're just going, oh no, it's just Parks Canada, where there was nothing else, no other conference, nothing else going on. I mean, if it had gone well, they would probably be bragging about it and posting all over, and it would be all over the news about how it was this International Women's Firefighting Conference, and look how good they did. But since it went a little bit poorly, there's just a lot of silence on the matter. And I would have green screened in the article that was talking about how this conference was happening, but I don't know how. So just, you can Google it. You can Google the, like, International Women in Firefighting Conference, Banff, Alberta, and you'll see it. And they're talking specifically about this planned controlled burn. Just thought it was kind of funny.
You're posting a bikini picture compared to me being on a strip pole dancing and going crazy and being on ceilings, you know, like that. I was crazy party lifestyle promoter. I was doing everything, nightlife. I was making my money. And at the end of the day, it gets to a point where it's like, It's all fun and games, yeah. But look where I'm at right now.
No, I
had a child out of wedlock. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I don't have a man that is secure by my side right now with my child. And as I'm raising my child, I'm seeing how badly, at the end of the day, it's important to have a man. You know, like, it's really important because of the simple fact that just seeing my son raised without a son, like a father, it hurts. It really does. And you know what? I'm happy for you because it's like when you have that situation, you realize that it's like, this is my man. I'm going to worship him. And this is the family I'm going to create. When I'm a grandma and I have the whole entire room filled with my grandchildren, that is your real value.
Any attempt to restrict drinking and driving here is viewed by some as downright undemocratic.
It's kind of getting common this when a fella can't put in a hard day's work, put in 11, 12 hours a day, and then get in your truck and at least drink one or two beers.
They're making it laws where you can't drink when you want to. You have to wear a seatbelt when you're driving. And pretty soon we're going to become this country.
One of the worst things we can do as men is to be with women who don't want us. I've been in that position too. I have simped. I've been in the friend zone. I've done all that kind of stuff. And I will tell you, gentlemen, don't do it. Never do that. It's never a good idea. I said it 2 weeks old. Stop trying to win women over. And see, that's the beautiful thing about becoming a high value man. You don't have to win women over. You deal with the women who show interest in you and want to get on your program and are proving their worth to you. You had to work to become a high value man. You don't have to work for a woman. A woman has to work for your last name. She has to work for your ring. She has to work for your commitment. This is the game. Because we grew up in Disney and we were told that it was us that needed to do the other. That's why they hate these channels. They hate the channels where we start telling men, no, 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 no. If you have made yourself in the top 20%, top 10% of men, the rules are different for you.
Mace is crazy. Nah, she just faced it. Nah.
Nah, I gotta go. Hold on.
No.
Over the phone is crazy. I need my phone.
Look at this nigga.
Watch out, watch out, man.
Don't go in there.
Watch out.
Don't go back to the
back.
I need
my
phone.
Are you going
anywhere?
They ran up to that white lady in front of her apartment, just beat the shit out of her.
Horrifying.
But this is happening in modern 2023 in Chicago. Mm. Giant groups of kids just beating a lady up for no reason.
Because she was white.
Yeah.
She probably never even seen a fight, let alone been in a fight.
Complete terror.
And there's all hands of all different angles just beating you. What brings you to the state of, I just got to beat someone? It's madness.
It's also a recognition that law enforcement has lost control. Like the fact that they can do that, and they think they can do that as little kids. There's like young teenagers doing this, smashing windows and meeting up in groups of hundreds.
Okay, so we just met in the lobby, and I have a question for you.
What's up?
I want you to give me your honest answer.
All right, I'll try my best.
Okay, would you date me long term?
Well, since my name is Johnson, I have a few questions that I need to ask.
Okay.
Preliminary, if that's all right with you.
It's okay with me.
Yeah, first question is, do you have, you know, a stable income as far as also a lot of savings built up, 20K at least?
No.
Do you have, you know, a lot of guys that you talk to, or are you more of a monogamous type of woman?
I talk to a few guys.
Okay. My final follow-up question was, you know, would you be posting a lot of provocative pictures online, or are you more of a church type of girl?
I haven't been to church in years, and yes, I post a lot of provocative things online.
All right, well, I'm going to need you to exit my table.
What?
Por favor.
Oh, my God.
Hey, Laura, no.
Okay.
I want to start off by saying I love their energy, and I probably jammed with them for a little bit until, you know, I got tired and went to do my own thing. But this is disrespectful. It is. We're already packed in here like sardines, and I can't escape. They can't escape. So we should have like a minimum level of respect for each other on however long this flight is. I love that they're happy. I love that they're having a good time. I really do. They seem like they're in complete joy, and clearly they don't care, but y'all, this is disrespectful. Yeah. But yeah, the seats are cramped and there's not enough leg room. We all just want to get through the flight. So headphones are much appreciated. What do y'all think? Comment below. Follow for more.
Esme runs from the apartment and into the lift. She presses the button. Takes a few moments before the incredible Esme attack. She gives herself two uppercuts to her face and clutches her cheek. She then checks her handiwork in the mirror. Seemingly satisfied with her self-inflicted punishment, Esme eagerly waits for the lift door to open. She takes off down the hall and into the street to call police. Oblivious to what his wife had cooked up and concerned for her safety, Faisal also went to the police, where he was arrested and charged with assault. If convicted, he faced up to 7 years behind bars.
I didn't know that she went to that. She's going to go to that extent, go to the police and forget everything what I did for her and just ruin my life.
In a follow-up sucker punch, Faisal says the police unwittingly helped Esme steal his things, which she had packed into these suitcases while he was being held at the station. But more importantly, Faisal's freedom was also about to be taken.
Did you ever harm Esme?
Never. I really loved her.
Faisal spent 20 grand on a lawyer and trawled through hours of CCTV to find his get-out-of-jail card.
Savings? What are
those? I looked at your bank account.
Yeah.
You have this much. Not $5,000. $5. In the savings account. So where does your income come from now?
Now it comes from child support.
Child support?
Yes.
Okay. And how much is that per month?
It's $25,000.
$25,000. Yeah. Okay. Okay. That makes sense. And how much does it cost just to live for you on a given month?
With this house, it costs a lot. Probably like $15,000.
$15,000 just to keep the lights on?
Yeah. But I'm selling my house now.
This house?
Yes.
Okay. Why now?
You know, it's very big for me, and it's a lot of maintenance.
Look. Come on, man. Come on, man. I ain't doing that. Straight up. Ain't no po-ass not like that. But come on. We gotta do better, ladies. For real. Yeah. Hey, mama. Uh-huh. Yeah, I'm about to eat right now, mama. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we at a little restaurant. Yeah, the girl I was telling you about from Instagram that I met, it's Nia. Say what's up, Nia.
Hi.
Yeah, this is the kids, right? Y'all say hi, kids.
Hi.
Uh-huh. Yeah, this is LaKayla, she's 5, that's Timmy, he's 7, and this Sheree, she's 17. Uh-huh, right. So what you gonna be doing later, mama? All right. Well, let me just give you a call back later then. Mm-hmm. How the food is, kids?
Good.
It's good? Look like your food good. You eating a whole lot over there. What's up, mama? What about you? How you feeling?
Everything is good.
Y'all think y'all gonna get something to eat to go? Come on now, I got it. I can handle it. Let's make sure they eat enough food. They good.
I don't know. I may get a to-go box for the kids.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, get enough. Y'all make sure y'all fill it. Y'all plate up, all right?
All right.
Yeah, so when you get you one, make sure you get men one too, so you feel me? I got it, I'm gonna handle it.
All right.
Let me run to the car real quick. Let me go grab my wallet. I'll all be right back.
Okay, no problem. Mm-hmm.
I have been so hesitant to post about this for two reasons. Number one, I don't like negativity and I don't want to be like the bearer of bad news. Number two, I didn't want to believe it. But after doing so much research and getting a lot of messages, I'm going to just deliver the unvarnished truth to you guys. I'm just going to lay it out straight. We're in a dating crisis. Not basically, we are. That's what's happening. So let me look at my research here, because I don't want to mess it up. So men looking for casual dates and our relationships is down 50%, 50, since 2019. Not since 1970, since 2019, right before the pandemic, down 50%. They're not fucking looking, which means if you're a woman looking, they don't fucking give a shit. So as this trend continues, by 2040, 45% of women, 45% of women between the ages of 20 and 45 will be single and childless based on this trend. Let that sink in for a moment. I'm going to talk a lot more about this. So if you're interested in this topic, hit the follow button because I've got a lot more of information, a lot more to share with you guys.
Here's your half.
Why? Why can't I have that half?
Okay, here.
But why did you want to give me that to begin with?
It's the same thing. It's the same thing. It's literally the same sandwich cut in half.
But why didn't you want to give me that one first?
I don't care which one you want. Here, you want this one? Take it.
No, I want that one now. Blaze!
What one do you want now? It's the same fucking sandwich.
Never mind. I don't want anything.
They're going after your right to get a divorce. Yeah, you heard that right. Right when-
Well guys, there you go. They're upset because they can't get half to all your shit so easy anymore. That's really what it's about. They don't give a damn about no marriage. They don't love you. They just want half to all of your stuff. How do you think the majority of them got them houses? They didn't get it because they got credit. They ain't got no job. And if they do got a job and ain't enough to buy a house, they got it off that man. And then they can't afford to live there, so they gotta sell it. They know what they're doing. It's a hustle. That hustle's over, though. Okay? It's over. Beat it.
You're very harsh with a lot of things, so I wonder maybe what your childhood was like or how school was for you, how women were towards you.
Marin, who hurt you, Marin?
I'm serious. I'm serious. When
Marin,
I watched...
Who hurt you, Marin?
Well, this is actually an excellent question because you want to know something. It was my mom that taught me a lot of this stuff.
Okay.
All right, I grew up in a two-parent household. Strong masculine father, feminine mom. My parents are still together to this day, very stable household. We didn't grow up rich. I had to figure that out on my own. But it was actually my mom that warned me and told me, hey, don't marry an American woman. They're not going to treat you well. They're not going to cook and clean and take care of the house and all this other stuff. Don't marry a Western woman. I was like, Mom, what the fuck is wrong with you? Then as I got older, I started to realize, like, damn, a lot of Western women do have really bad habits that aren't conducive to a good long-term relationship. And guys really got to step their masculinity up to command respect from their girl and get her to submit.
I want you to make it hard on your competition. I want you to make it hard on the women who want to be in your life. Because if you're going to win, you're going to get out there and do what it takes to succeed. And I wonder you'll get all the results. What do you think? Client people out here are the millionaires and billionaires, people who are rich and wealthy. What do you think they do? They still eat. Well, you know what? I'm eat spam. I'm eat peanut butter and jelly because I don't want a man to forget that mess. Many people don't know how rich and wealthy people actually live, but I tell you what, they don't live worrying about what people who have less than them think about them. They really don't. They may say it in public, but they don't. Tywin Lannister, the lion doesn't concern himself with the opinions of the sheep. What do you want to be? If you want to be a lion, guess what? You're going to have to eat some sheep. You're going to have to eat a whole bunch of stuff, and none of your prey likes to be eaten. What are you going to do? Become a vegetarian? Go eat some grass? Go be nice to it? Talk to it? Man, be a lion. Do what you have to do. Embrace the arrogance. It's one of your superpowers.
You hate arguing with men. You genuinely believe they were of lower intelligence than women. Sweetheart, they built the phone that you're using in your hand. They invented the app that you're uploading this video on. They invented the electrical circuits that you have running in your house to give you electricity. They invented the car that you drive to your local vegan supermarket to get your groceries. And since you hate this society so much that was built by men, then why don't you go move to this matriarchy? It's a true blue no man's land because men are banned. I will buy you your plane ticket to go to Umoja, Kenya. The only condition is that you can't come back to this super patriarchal, misogynistic, sexist society that you clearly detest so much. Damn, that's tough.
Theo, this is Greg from Indiana. So me and my friends went out and caught your show. Dude, you did phenomenal. I actually just wanted to call and tell you, so I was at work the other day, and I've just been kind of in this like rut at work. Not a bad job, but I just really want to get out of it. So I was catching up on some of your podcasts, and you said something that like resonated with me. You know, you said, nothing changes if nothing changes. I thought about it, and I went home and I applied for a job I'm probably not qualified for, but I was like, I'll take a shot. And the next day I get a call from them, have the interview, it goes well. She says she's going to set me up with an in-person interview. Never even had it. They email me a few days later and I got the job. So now I'm going to be doing a job that I think I will appreciate more and enjoy more, and I'll be making double the money that I'm making now.
Gang.
Man. Women are something else, you know? I don't like to talk about them for long, to be honest, because they always leave me with a strong depression. Let's keep going. What do you think about how... It's just true. I don't know. I got in my feelings.
I thought there was a question following.
No, like that was just facts.
Straight statement.
Yeah, that was just real life. What do you think? This is my question. This is something that...
You're a man. You are a man. Stand up and be a man. Make the hard decisions. Make the sacrifices. Make the unpopular decisions. And become comfortable in your own skin.
Okay, lady, when I become a successful writer, there'll be no house for you. Yep. There's no vacation for you. No Elvis Cadillac for mommy. You get nothing because you said that.
And did you stick to that?
Yeah.
That is not how this debt works. It demands a result, not an appeasement. There is a hook in me. One that you cannot see. But it is there.
The Bible. The role of a wife is characterized by respect, submission, and support. It is described as a partnership where the wife is called to fulfill specific responsibilities within the marriage. One of the key passages that speaks to the role of a wife is found in the New Testament book of Ephesians. It instructs wives to submit to their husbands as to the Lord, emphasizing the importance of mutual respect and cooperation within the marriage relationship. Submission in this context does not imply inferiority or oppression, but rather a willingness to respect and honor the husband's leadership. It involves recognizing the husband as the head of the household and willingly following his lead, while both partners submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. A biblical wife is called to support and encourage her husband, to be his helper and companion. She is instructed to love and respect her husband, just as the church is called to love and respect Christ. This includes showing appreciation, affirming his strengths, and being a source of comfort and encouragement. Furthermore, a biblical wife is encouraged to prioritize the well-being of her family and home. She is called to create a nurturing and loving environment, caring for the needs of her children and managing the affairs of the household. This includes being diligent in managing resources, practicing hospitality, and cultivating a peaceful and harmonious atmosphere. In addition, a biblical wife is called to cultivate inner beauty,